Okay, so we're back at this motherboard, and yesterday I said I was going to do a quick heat check, so that's what I'm going to do now. Let's disassemble this board and have a look under the thermal cam, see what happens. Okay, I think that's all we need. We'll put the battery into it so it doesn't keep forgetting the CMOS information. It will save us from having to wait for the enter screen. Okay, that's good. Okay, that's the hard drive cover. Get this environment ready. So technically the board does work. There's no immediate shorts, but I believe the component is most likely getting hot and hence it's turning off. The power supply is currently off. Good. Okay, let's bring in the thermal camera. Okay, so let's see what is, if anything, is getting hot that's causing this problem. Okay. Okay, so we're at the super IO section. Reset the power. Power is nice and cool. It's a little bit hot today. Okay. What's the voltage set? 19 volts, 5 amps. Power is currently on. It's pulling 0.02. That's interesting. Why is he already going up? That to me already says there is a problem. Let's cut the power. Okay, let's focus on that guy. What's happening there? Cut the power. I haven't even turned the unit on. Immediately we're on to possibly a success. Let's see. Five X equals two. Oh, that cap there looks dodgy. Okay. Bring in the multimeter. Yep. And light on. Well, let's go have a look in continuity. There may be a partial short. He's fine. Let's check the ground. 25, that's ground. Okay, let me just check behind him quickly. What's behind him? So right behind him is here. Just check anything out of the ordinary there. Okay, just check those gates, the ground. So they're not short at the ground. And how about the MOSFETs that this guy's adjoined to? Check them out. Okay, to ground. So it's one of the two things. The color of the cap kind of makes me think that's bad, but I've seen the same color cap on the other side, which makes me want to rule that out. See that one there on the left, same color. Here, the one on the left, same color. Okay. Okay, so I'm not gonna touch that chip yet. I don't think it's faulty yet. Okay, so no power in the system yet. Power is currently off, but that's what's pulling power when we turn on the power. Power on. Here we go. Could be that chip is gone or faulty, we don't know. Let's check around here. Power is on. And around here. Okay, I'm going to press the power button here. Power light is on. It's gone off. Okay. And let's check that chip out again. Power button on. So that's the chip there in question. Seems we have a large heat spot around there. That's the BQ chip. So let's cut this power. Okay. Power cable plugged in. And we have that heat signature from the other side of that chip, which is already getting hot. And now if I press the power button, the BQ chip should be getting really hot. Okay. I'm going to focus on that LX chip, sorry, 5X chips. So what we'll do is have a look on the microscope again and just check its surroundings. So cut the power, continuity. Oh, he's definitely gone bad. Okay. Yeah, he's partially shorted. Let me just remove him, see what happens. I'll be right back. All right, so remove that cap and it would be nice to know where I put it. Oh, there it is. Okay, now what do I replace it with? I have no idea, but we can make a guesstimate. So that's next to another capacitor, that's the 5X chip. By the way, before we replace it with another cap, let's check if the resistance again, not resistance, that's ground. Okay, that's not ground, you see. So I think a capacitor might have partially shorted on the inside. So what should I pick out of here? I have no idea. This is a donor board. Not a donor board, it's just another board. Yeah, just one of these. Let's just see what happens. In terms of comparison, that's perfect. What I'm doing is not ideal. It's not the right way to do things. You should measure what you need. Okay, so let's observe what happens when we attempt to turn it on. Much lower voltage drop, unless if it makes sense if I try reversing. Yeah, before it was 25 something, now it's 40 something, same as the one next to it. Okay, let's plug in the power. Power is currently off. Power on. 0.02. Power on. exactly the same situation and check that capacitor that I took out. So he's actually good. Okay, so let's put him back and find a chip called 5X. Yeah, we do have six of them at number 21. Okay. What we'll do then is what we shall do. Let's put that capacitor back first thing first. Before that, we'll remove this chip. Okay, number 21. That is a very shitty soldering. Okay, this turned out to be really ugly. Fucking hell. I didn't get a good hold of it. Okay. I'll be right back. All right, we're back. And so I replaced that chip and the cap. That's it there. Put that cap back, actually. Okay, so let's see the behavior of the motherboard now. Power on 0.04. Nah, so that chip was actually okay. Problem is elsewhere. Okay. Okay. Let's have another look on the thermal cam. The power is on. Let's have a look at that chip area again. So it's something on the right side of it. Why? Why? It's like it's telling me the problem is there, but I don't know where the problem is. Okay. Something there. Is there any short there? I mean, we're running at 51 degrees. Let's check. We're in continuity mode. Okay, then in that case, let's check out this chip's specifications and see if I can find a schematics for this board. I'll be right back. All right, so no schematics available at the moment, but the 5X chip is a rich tech. 65 RT6575C or D. Okay, so this is a RT6575DGQW. Okay, so the area that's getting hot. We got no power in the system. Give this a quick clean so we can see what we're looking at. Okay, so that's the dot there. So that will be 5, 10, 15. So around here, 20, 19, 18, 17. Let's have a look at them. 20 is enable, 19 is VCLK, phase 1, boot, U-gate 1. Okay. So pin is current sense. Current limiting sensing, connect the resistor to ground. Okay. That will be pin number one. Feedback voltage input for channel one. That's number two, three, four, five. So nothing here is going to ground yet. Six, seven, eight, nine, ten. And then 11, 12, 13, 13. Why is this randomly doing this? So 12 and 13, are they interchanging? 5 volt linear regulator output is also the supply voltage for the low side MOSFET and analog supply voltage for this device. So I see low side voltage. So this one is connected to the MOSFET gate, most likely. No? Okay, maybe somewhere else. Let me check. Okay, on the other side there are some MOSFETs. I'm just gonna check if there's a connection to there. some reason I'm getting a really weird, like sometimes the reading, sometimes not. I think that's connected to a MOSFET. I've got to find which MOSFET that guy belongs to. I think that's our problem. So number 12 is voltage in. So this will be voltage in. Let me check the voltages as I plug it in, yeah? Voltage mode. Let's get the power supply. Power supply is currently on. It's probably already heating up. Yeah, 5 volts. Here will be high voltage, correct. But for 5 volt, I bet you that's a very low resistance. And I think that's a MOSFET, wherever that MOSFET is. Check resistance. Yeah, for 5 volt, 14 ohms is not correct. Okay, that's where the problem is. Okay, so if I remove this cap, we're not going to have 5 volt issue. So, okay. So we're on the money here. Depending on the currency you live in. Okay, so 5 volt rail, probably that one there. Looking for 14 ohms. Yeah, most likely that guy or the MOSFETs there, that's our problem. Okay, then what we'll do, we'll quickly check the MOSFETs there before doing any sort of injection. Microscope, here we go. So some, hopefully one of these guys. Okay, gate to source. And gate to source. Okay, gate to ground. Gate to ground. And this coil. Really hard, isn't it? Okay, let's plug the power in. This time we're just going to measure the coils, find out which one is generating our voltage that we're interested in. We're in voltage mode. No voltage there. No voltage there. Not that one. Sorry. That's so interesting. I would have expected these guys to be, you know, the 5 volt and the 3 volts always on, but we don't have anything here. Or, okay. Let me try power on the unit while I put my probe there. Okay, this is 3.3. And that's the 5 volts there. Okay. For 5 volts, that is a very low resistance. To ground. Power is slightly going down now. Yeah, okay. This one is tricky. Something on the 5-volt line. Okay, let's remove this coil. That's a 5-volt coil. We do get it, but it doesn't stay long. We don't have always on rail either. Okay, we're in resistance mode. Let's check one side. And let's check the other side. Okay. Okay. And we're going to now plug in the power, and I want to see if we get our 3 volts here. We're not going to have a charging light, because, oh, we do have, okay. So that's LDO out, okay. Let's check the voltage on, no voltage yet. Okay, cut the power, just have a look here. Yeah, we got 5 volts. Okay. It's a bit shitty. I don't know what I'm doing yet. Okay. Let's go ahead and inject some power. Let's say 5 volts. Voltage. That's the wrong one. Voltage. And current 0.5. Okay. Okay. Now we got ground in the motherboard. We're just gonna, yeah, maybe let's not be stupid. Voltage, let's bring to 1 volt. Let's just see the reaction on either side. Nothing. Nothing. Okay. Just check I've got it connected correctly. Yeah. Okay, voltage 2 volts. Go in either place. Here we go. Nothing. Okay, this one's doing something. Voltage 3 volts. Nothing. Yeah, okay, we do know our problem. Okay. Whatever it is, we found that. Okay. Voltage 5. Okay, that's our problem most likely. So now we need to bring in the thermal camera again. It's a very messy setup here. It is not messy, I just don't have enough room. Okay. Okay. Okay, show me what's getting hot at 5 watts. That would be nice in the future, we can say that to computers. Okay. Again? I see. Something there. One more time. Looks like a capacitor, eh? Nope, it's on the right side. Something here. Let me check there. These are resistors. Got so many probes here. Okay, which one is which? Okay. We're in voltage mode. Let's have a look in resistance mode. So whatever it is, it's not these two. Is going to ground. That's going to ground. He's not going to ground. Neither is he. Ten kilo ohms, okay. Interesting. What if it's something on the other side of that? It comes to here again. So what the hell is going on? Okay. I'm gonna have to run a wire. It's getting painful. Now we got our wire ready. Okay. Okay, so we're going to inject 5 volts now. Let's reset this temperature sensor. 5 volts. Do your magic. Ready? What the hell? I mean, we replaced that. This doesn't make sense. Let's remove that chip. Could it be we have a shitty chip? Who knows? And do I still have 5 volts going out? No. Yeah, I'm putting 5 volts in. Nothing happens. Okay. Pin number 13, yeah? So 13 will be him here. What will happen if I put 5 volts there? Nothing. It's definitely 5 volts, yeah. Okay. Power input, pin number 12, which will be here. Nothing. One, 15 and 6 are low gate and U gate. L gate, U gate. Low side, high side. So 15 and 16. The voltage, let's set it to 1 volt. 15 and 16 are. That's 16. Nothing. Low side, nothing. Pin number 3, let's have a look at that. Voltage, pin number 3, LDO3, 3.3 linear voltage regulator output. It's going there to here. And what if we put 3 volts there? that's the new chip that I had put in, which is not playing well. Okay. So what should I do? Should I try another chip maybe? Okay, so what we're gonna do is actually get one more chip. Was it location 21? Yeah, this one has a little bit of marks. This one is from a used one, meaning it will be more reliable because it's from a previous working system. Okay. Okay. So if I apply 5 or 3 volts even, yeah, it's still getting hot. 3 volts. This is not normal. So just injecting 3 volts to the coil. See that? And if you make that 5 volts, voltage set to 5, 0.5 amps. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so it's not this chip, it's the output of this chip. Okay. Okay, let's go back to this time, we're gonna measure the voltages. Current limit sensing, connect resistor to ground, set threshold, okay, no. Okay. Voltage. Yeah, we're not gonna do... No, we'll do voltage injection. Okay, voltage readings. Okay. So as I inject voltage, let's see what we read here. 1.49, okay. Okay. Pin number 1, what do we get for pin number 1? Okay, 0.4. Pin number 2, feedback. Which is same as what we're getting here. Similar, okay. Pin number 3? No, that was 1, 2. What's pin number 2? Okay, LDO 3. Okay, let's check that. So that's 1, 2, 3. So that should be 3.3. Okay, so what we're going to do is this. Our problem is not on the 5 volt coil. Maybe, maybe not. Okay, we're not 100% sure. To make our job easy, we're gonna remove this guy. Okay. Okay. This time we're going to go straight to 19 volts into the power adapter. Look at that, 5 volts in the DC jack is already taking power, which it shouldn't. Okay, voltage. Yep, here we go. We're in voltage mode. Let's check what's happening. Pin number 1. Oh, beautiful rain finally. Okay, 5 volts, 19 volts, so that's fine. Feedback number 2, which goes there, which is 0 at the moment. Okay, how about number 3? 3.3. Feedback for volt number, feedback 2. Interesting. I wonder if it's connected to the BQ chip that's also getting hot. Pin number 5. Nothing. Pin number 6, nothing. Enable control. Okay, number 7 is power good. So it's not getting a power good. Number 8, switch node of channel 2. Nothing. Okay, I'm gonna focus on, let's cut the focus from this chip. I think the biggest elephant in the room is him. BQ737. Let's have a look at him first. We've got no power in the system, just in continuity. Seems a bit too low, okay. I feel like he's also getting hot, you know. Okay, one way to know is we remove this BQ chip, see if it still gets hot. Okay. The board is working. Nah. Shit, it wants more amps, okay. How can the board turn on without that? Okay, amp. Here we go. Recipe for disaster. So let's put a 5 volts through that again, I think. Or we just plug in the power but we don't turn it on. Shit, there's a dead short, okay. So it's a bad idea to turn it on without a BQ chip. Okay. Just curious to see what really got hot there. Something's got really, really, really hot there. Okay, why don't we reduce the voltage to 5 volts. Okay, those two MOSFETs. P7410, okay. P7410. Okay, so 30 volts, 26 milliohms, and 24 amps. Okay. All right, We got something else, 272 location. These will be compatible. 1 and 2. Okay. Okay, and a BQ chip, let's put that guy back. Do I have any? Yeah, number 84. Let's just use a new one. kind of see the correct side. I think that should be the correct side. I hope the orientation is correct. Yeah, the dot seems to be on the correct position. Okay. Let's bring our 5 volts and let's see what happens to this power supply. We're back to the same shit. No. At 5 volts, if it's taking such an amp. Voltage 7 volts. Voltage 10 volts. Voltage 19 volts. Yeah, same probably situation. Press the power button. It's still on and shut down. Power on. Fan spin. Shut down. No, not yet. Yeah, there we go. Shut down. I'll be right back. Okay. We don't have a success. It's pretty much a shit show at the moment. Definitely the chip is in properly. I'll push it down a little bit more. Yeah, I don't believe what they said about that it was off for a while and they just turned it on, etc. And this problem. I think originally they had an issue with this anyway. That's why they're getting it repaired now. So, ¥19. We get a orange light. Something is eating up power, of course. Power button. And it turns off. Same behavior as before. And most likely that chip there is burning again. No, that's quick, eh? But he is hot. Something turns on then turns off. What the fuck can it be? So it's not the BQ chip. I can put this chip back. Same scenario. Okay, I really don't know. I'm stuck. That's the 3 volts. How can 3 volts be so low? That's the 5 volts. All right, so 5 volts has shit itself. Okay. So 3 volts, that is. Maybe that's where the issue is the whole time. and which side is lower. This is the weirdest system ever, mate. Let's just do some voltage injection. I don't even know what's going on anymore. We're basically having a meltdown here. Nothing. Something. Okay. Voltage 2 volts. Okay. Hopefully it's not the PCH. What a fucking time waste that will be. We can think about, maybe we fix the 5-volt rail, I don't know. And then now the 3.3-volt rail. Just an assumption. Here we go. Yeah, and the short magically disappeared, of course. Fucking hell. It's not there anymore. Nothing's happening. Now the resistance, if I measure, will have gone up now. So there's no point measuring the resistance, but I'll measure it anyway. There's no power in the system. One leg of 3.3. It's going back down now. How about him? Such a weird system, eh? Okay. Okay, 3.3. Show us your problem. Here we go. Nothing. No. I don't know what it could be. Replace MOSFETs, BQ chip, 5X chip, we injected power at 5 volts rail, we injected power at 3.3 volt rail, we're not having any happy days. Okay. What are you doing at 0.03? It's burning that chip. I don't know why. One last time, thermal check, and that will be it. I'll move on to the other jobs. This one for future learning. Power is in. Is the super ray getting hot? Have a look at that. Okay. Usually a reflection. Okay. Doesn't feel hot. So I've got no power at the moment, so no point for him to be shining. Hello, SureCan speaking.
Hello, SureCan, Michael. How are you?
Hey, mate.
I've got it at home. I just plugged everything in. Pull the cable back. And it won't turn on.
Check the power switch. Make sure it's in the on position. Or I'll send you another invoice, $99. No problem. That's good. Alright, you come and fix this problem here, mate. You come and fix this problem here. I'll fix yours. You come and fix some. Trying to fix the laptop here. It's not working. Alrighty, mate. No worries. Take care. Bye bye. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna give up on this job. Such as such. Two of these I couldn't fix. Can you believe it? U, that's the family. Okay, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to support this channel.